We do see some very clear features there.
Let's see if we can get it out. The handle still works. It's closed, so let's see if there's something inside. I'm back on the road with the Iron Mike metal detecting. We're gonna do some detecting in a German forest. The British troops were advancing through this area. The Germans were fighting back, and we are very sure that we will find some traces of the battles that took place here, and we will definitely show you. First signal of the day. Let's see if you can find it here. That's actually an English buckle. Yeah, that's quite a nice find. I think it's from a canvas belt that they would wear around the waist. So that's proof of the British soldiers that fought here. And I'm very pleasantly surprised. We are trying out a new location. It's a very nice buckle. We don't find British stuff too often, so I'm happy that we're finding that once again and that we're detecting an area where the British soldiers have been. So this is going to be a promising day. I just wanted to show you the second signal of the day. Here is where I just dug up the first buckle, and right next to it another buckle just came up. And I think this is a buckle from a piece of canvas fabric which was wrapped around the ankle. Basically they could tighten it up with this buckle, so again a British find. Here's just a quick close-up of all of the buckles that I just dug out. It's definitely from multiple belts. Well, I guess they just threw some belts in the forest here. They didn't need it anymore. While I was digging up all those buckles over there, Mike was digging out something that looks like a field radio over here. And he's dug quite a big hole. Quite a lot of relics came out altogether.
Yeah, these Bakelite parts. I think that's the outside of the radio. These old batteries.
Batteries, yeah.
Yeah, and there's a fuse. I must. These glass fuses.
Well, yeah, it definitely looks like it could be a part of an old field radio.
Yeah, I think it is. There's some switch over here. It's pretty heavy, so yeah. Let's support that.
Yeah, well, at least we know how they communicated in this forest, at least. I was digging here and all of a sudden I saw a roundish shape. You can see it over there already. What is that? Maybe it's I've seen something similar before, I think, at least. It's some sort of an equipment tag, Werkzeugmarke in German, that is. And there is writing on it, but I'm not sure yet what it says. So let's give it a brush and see what this piece of history tells us. I just brushed it up, and as you can see, it says Tuchhose 1. Tuchhose 1, and in the middle it says 192. So yeah, it definitely seems like some sort of tag, perhaps an equipment tag, or maybe it was a tag that soldiers put on their duffel bag to make sure they didn't lose their stuff. Quite an interesting find, very intriguing. Really hope we're gonna find out what it is exactly. Research pointed out that it is indeed some sort of equipment tag. Tuchhose means trousers. This was a part of the German uniform. The other markings indicate the tag ID, soldier ID, and regiment number. Looks like we have yet another equipment tag right here. But it appears that this one is in half. I do see an opening here, so a chain could have been run through it. And there's probably some writing on it. Really curious what type of tag this one is. It's yet another one, and this one says Mantel, which means overcoat. Here's an interesting little surface find. I think it's a British grenade. Not really sure how this was called, but the fuse is made from Bakelite, as you can see. And yeah, this one has definitely gone off. No explosive charge left. There's even some cloth still on it. But the as the fuse is made from Bakelite, it's still intact. It turns out this is a British number 77 incendiary smoke grenade. Interesting find. My buddy just found something interesting over here. And I actually also had a signal right next to him. Well, I just found a shell casing and he found some sort of a plate. We found out that this is a British Army metal dinner plate. There appears to be some paper inside. It's coming loose already. And let me see if I can focus that. I think it's actually English writing. I see the word day over here. There, day. Today's a good day. It's clearly English writing, but not sure what this article was about, unfortunately. We just found a World War II plate over there. At least that's what we think it is. Right next to it, I just pinpointed a nice small signal over here. It looks like a button, and I think it's something that I found in the past before. I believe it's a Canadian button, so I thought let's do this brush together and let's see if something will appear. Isn't that a British button? It's not the Canadian one, you see that? It's a different symbol. So this is actually a first for me, I've never found this before. That's a very neat button. We found three of these nice British buttons already. And the fourth one came out right now. And I think this is a smaller one. But it's probably a British one as well. I'll clean it up and show you the final result. I just gave this smaller button a clean. And it has a different pattern than the other ones, as you can see. So it's a different type of button, maybe a different type of uniform, different rank. Right here we discovered three general service buttons and one Royal Tank Regiment button. Guys, I'd like to take a moment to tell you a little something about ticks. I've been getting a lot of questions about them and I've also been bitten quite a couple of times myself. So I was in need of better protection against them. And I'm actually wearing that protection right now. I got these clothes from Rovins, which is a company specialized in designing tick-proof clothing. All of their products are impregnated with a substance which temporarily paralyzes ticks in order to prevent them from biting you. They fall down before they even get the chance to bite you. Besides this, it's also good quality working clothes. Yeah, I'm really happy with it. You'll probably see me wear these clothes more often from now on. So if you like these products, go to rovins.com and check it out for yourself. We've been digging up quite a lot of 25-pounder material the last 15 minutes. Found quite some transportation caps, or caps that went on the fuse of the 25-pounder. And this is a transportation rack. There will be four grenades in these holes, and there will be another one, another plate on top. And the grenades will be in between, and then they could be transported without colliding into each other and stuff like that. Getting quite excited here. We do see some very clear features there, so I guess we're gonna dig it all the way out. It'll probably take a while, and I'll get back to you when we know more or see more. Well, it seems to be quite a large box. I don't think it's an MG42 box. It's probably a British 25-pounder one. We've been finding all sorts of material, 25-pounder material, transportation caps, fuses, racks, stuff like that. We just pulled out a K98 ammo pouch. It's in 100 pieces, unfortunately. But that's interesting. Next to this ammo box, big question is there something in it? It's a British 25-pounder box for sure. Recognize these square handles. Is there something inside? I'm standing on the wrong side, I think.
Oh, it's empty. I think it's empty. But it's still a nice find.
Definitely,
still
yeah.
Is.
We also just pulled out this beer bottle. It's a British beer bottle. Although we're in Germany, this clearly is English writing. The soldiers probably have been drinking this beer and enjoying themselves. They were off duty, I guess. Made in England, very nice.
Here you can see another grenade rack right there. And here, I think that's the corner piece of an ammo box. And there are signals everywhere here. Well, I'm really doing my best here, but it seems that there's multiple boxes in this hole. There's one here, there's one there, and I'm not sure how many more there are, but okay, there's movement here. I think the first box I can get out. I think the grenade rack is still in it. There, they must have had big guns here, that's for sure. The British 25 pounder gun was the main field artillery weapon during the Second World War. It could be used for both direct fire and high angle fire. The 25 pounder boxes were often filled with sand and used by soldiers to build defensive structures around their artillery positions. Time to close up. Me and Mike both just discovered more boxes, World War II boxes, British artillery stuff. But yeah, hopefully these ones still have some shell casings inside, because we haven't found those yet. But yeah, it's very thrilling to find these boxes. You never know if there's gonna be something in it or not. Just a short update. I've been digging for 10 minutes maybe. You can very clearly make out the contours of this ammo box. Well, it definitely is an ammo box, I already recognized it. So yeah, let's see if we can pull it out. Finally, it's loose. Let's see if we can get it out. The handle still works. It's closed, so let's hope there's something inside. There you go, British 25 pounder ammunition box. Let's see if there's something inside. Unfortunately not, only sand. It's a pity. Maybe we are lucky with the other ones. I just had a couple of signals here and I already saw one object that I know, that I recognized. This is a British L-strap buckle. So there will be a canvas belt running through this in an L shape. And I think there's more signals here. Yeah, that's what I thought. And there's yet another buckle. Maybe this one went with the L-strap buckle, I'm not sure. But yeah, I guess we're gonna dig all of these signals out and let's see what comes up. And right next to me, yeah, it's a mortar protection cap. It says remove before firing. And I think this is the bigger one. So this one went on the 2-inch mortar. Yeah, nice one. Well, this is the final result. I really believe that we've hit a 25 pounder artillery position. I mean, so many ammunition boxes, some fuses as well. This stuff is also really interesting. I think in English it's called cordite, if I translate that correctly. But that would have been in the 25 pounder shell, in the casing basically. And yeah, I think you can still set this on fire. You shouldn't mess with it too much. Two English beer bottles and a bunch load of these boxes. Very cool. That was it for today. We're gonna go home. We had a beautiful day. A big thank you, of course, to all of my patrons. Your names will appear somewhere in the screen right now. See you guys next video.